people are having fun at the boat ride. So we went back to the hotel for breakfast, then went to the pool, rest a little bit, have lunch, then now we are coming back again to the same place, to the deer cave, and then after that we're going to watch the, what they call, the bat flying up on the cave.
Come over here and then wait for the guide. There is toilet over there, but it's the better toilet at the cafe at the back with air conditioning. So we're going to do a quick briefing right over here, then we'll go to the deer cave and then watch the bat flying up on the cave. Today the guide with us is Nicholas. Yep, so he is the one to bring us to the cave, and then we'll show you more what we can expect. We were passing by this area this morning, so there's something swimming in the river.
Look at this bubble.
Oh!
Nothing. A fish, a fish, a fish. 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 Yeah. Big fish, actually.
Yeah, there are some fishes there. So, if you're lucky, you can see some otter. And then we saw some London bug and snake worm. Yep.
We have one particular tree that we have here. So, long time ago, local people will go to this area and doing the chopping on this tree. You can see the marking of the chopping around this area. They will collect this latex of the tree from this kind of tree, bring it back, boil it until it turns to be like brownish color and it's very sticky. And then you can put the Indian of the darts inside it, maybe around this long or this long, to be a poison. So this kind of like tree, we call it like a poison tree. Normally local, long time ago, try to collect the latex over here, and then they would do the process like cooking it, put it in the dart and dry it, and after 5 days after you dry the poison in the other dart, you can use it for huntings, like using blowpipes. Okay, we arrived in the entrance over here. So for those of you guys want to see fish, we have fish down there. And then for those of you guys want to use the toilet, just go straight and turn to the right. We have toilet, proper toilets. And the small shelter over there next to the toilet will be smoking zone for those of you guys are smoking. Okay, like I said, we have small canteen just now. It's open. If you guys want to buy something like cold drinks, biscuits. Okay, we're gonna stop here for 5 to 10 minutes.
So this is a seat for to watch the bat, right?
Yes, this is the thing that we call like bat up to this area. You're gonna sit around this area. So the best view will be around that area, the last part, the tree row.
Okay. You can gotcha.
Down, and then the bat will fly up into the tree.
So the tip is from Nick is sit at the last tree row to watch the bat, and then now let me show you the toilet. So you might feel better in case your stomach is not well. Let's see, it's clean or not. Let's see, is there any snake inside? So we are everyone are having a short break over here, and let me check out the toilet. Surprisingly clean, very very clean toilet. I'm happy. This is a smoking area over here, and what is the one at the back? Washing zone?
This will be a water pump.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they will pumping the water for the toilets.
I see, thank you. So any smoker trying to smoke here, and then throw the cigarette butt right over here. Don't leave any trash when you visit this park. So after a few break, then we'll show you the cave. Check out this river, clear water and lots of fish. Nick, is the water drinkable? Or you boy, or you not suggest to drink?
I'm not suggest to drink.
After the gate, you see a lot of the tree full of flower, orange color, and the petals looks like this. Okay, good luck day, lucky day to see flower like that. We are at the entrance of the cave. It's beautiful. We can smell something like yogurt. So we are going to stop here for a quick briefing by Nick.
As you can see, like we have lung cave on this side, and then we have deer cave on that side. Okay. So before we enter the cave, I need to warn you about some of the rule and regulation that we have in the cave, the park, like do and don't. Okay. So normally when we say you can do, like just walk in the cave, taking photo, and then if you have your lights, like super bright lights, because in the cave we have few of the natural habitat that living in the cave, especially for the bats. So do not shine your direct light to the eyes of the bats, because you might hurt the bat. Maybe the bat will blind for a while. Okay, and then while we're working in the cave as well, like, do not go outside from the pathway that we have in the cave, because sampa actually are very slippery, like we have mud and everything, so you might slip and fall inside the cave later on. So that is the thing that you can do in the cave, but the thing that you can do not do actually is, like, you are not allowed to have a smoke in the cigarette, like in the cave. You are not allowed to drink in the cave and eat in the cave. If you eat or drink in the cave, I will say, like, you have extra flavor later on. The guano will drop down to your chips, and then yeah, okay. In the cave as well, like, we have a few of the things, like, along the walks we have few lights in the cave. So when I say, like, you need your headlamp or head torchlight, actually it's like maybe you want to point to something and want to take a photo, you have your own light to point. Okay. For the lung cave and deer cave, roughly, like, for both cave, actually, it's like we will spend around 1.5 hours to finish the two caves later on. So maybe this area maybe around 25 or half an hour walk later on, maybe, because we will enter the big chamber later on. Maybe some of you guys want to having extra time to take some photo, maybe for, like, Instagram, Facebook. Yes, why not? So along the way in the cave later on, we can just go walk directly. You can take less photo, but on the way back I will give you guys a time to take some good photo on the way back. We will enter the lung cave first, so we will stop in the entrance later on, and then we will do some briefing about the introduction of the cave. So welcome to lung cave. So it's not the biggest one that you can see here, but it will be the beautiful one that we have in Mulu for now. So it's a very small cave, but we have a lot of, like, beautiful formation that we have in the cave. So that's why they will turn the cave, like, very much more beautiful from the other cave. Because you will see, like, we have deer cave next ones. Tomorrow morning we have wind cave and clear water. But for this cave, actually, like, from the entrance to the back, like, we have very interesting formation that you can see in the cave later on. Okay? So for the lung cave itself here, actually, it's like, it's been discovered by the one of the guy, Mr. Lang Balare, before the major expedition in 1977. So he discovered this cave when he was, like, going for hunting around this area. When I said hunting, you can see the marking on the poison tree just now. So he collected latex and doing the hunting for a while around this area. And then this area long time ago was covered by some of the plants. So Mr. Lang actually following the footprint of one of the animals going into the cave on that time. So when he found the cave actually here, so when we have this major expedition came, he told to the major expedition, like, I found that one of the cave very close by. So he just bring the expedition group to get to this area and start to discover the cave, and they do the cave mapping around the cave. So example, if it Laurex, you are the founder of the cave, we will say, like, Laurex cave. So we will name the cave to the founder of the cave. Okay. So the cave itself over here is only 240 meters long, so roughly 25 minutes to half an hour walk in the cave. So we have a stalactite, stalagmite cave columns in the cave later on. You might see the jellyfish formation that we have in the cave. And then we have cave curtains and some of the things that in the ceilings, almost like a chandelier on top of the ceilings. And then we have a big chamber in the end. And before we enter as well, like, the limestone itself here, actually, it was formed around 20 to 40 million years ago. So we have mineral and carbon that been mixed together to form as a calcium carbonate, to form this kind of, like, big pile of limestone, and it's formed the big cave that we have here. So it was like different layer of limestone being compressed to each other by the ocean water long time ago, especially in the shallow water, like lagoon area. And then when we have this kind of, like, activity for the tectonic plate movings, so one of the tectonic plate been pushing to the top or one each other, and then the limestone exposed to the forest. But when we get exposed, so we have, like, vertical crack, we call it joints. So every joints that we have in the cave, our crack that we have in the cave, actually they get dissolved by the water, like rainfall. So rainfall will collect the carbon dioxide and turn the water to be acidic water. So when they land on the forest floor as well, because we have living microorganism on the soil, they will release extra carbon dioxide. So the water will turn to be more acidic water. So when they get to between the cracks, like, so this is the thing that we call cracks, okay? Like this one. Mm-hmm. So this is what we call cracks. So between the cracks, the limestone will dissolve the water will dissolve the limestone very aggressively. And maybe long time ago as well, like we have this ice age things happen as well, when the ice age melting, some of the caves that we have here will be underwater. So when we have the uplifting process as well, the water slowly like low down and then wash back to the sea. So some of the cave over here were leaving some of the proof from the water level that we have long time ago, like million years ago. So some of the cave that we have here estimate will be around 2.5 until 5 million years old cave. So they are very young cave, okay? But in the cave later on, you might spot like some of the cave sediments, like rock, pebble, clay, and sand that we have in the cave. So that will represent the water level that we have in this cave million years ago. So when I say like, when we go in, no touching some of the rock formations that we have in the cave, because we want to preserve some of the things that we have in the cave, maybe for your grandchildren. Okay? Maybe they will come back again, like, my grandfather been here before, I want to see. So when they come back, they can see the same things. Maybe a bit more difference. Maybe the rock formations are already getting bigger. Okay? So we will enter the cave. So walk slowly. We might spot something interesting in the cave. So enjoy your walk and be careful. Guys, if you come closer, I will point it only one time, okay? Because I'm using a pointer. This area, you can see like nectar bed roosting on the shillings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them up there. So for those of you guys want to take photo, yes. Just above your head here. Up here, guys. In the hole. We have fruit bags, we call it nectar bag. Short nose nectar bag. Yeah. Stalagmites. So when they combining each other, like the big one over here, this is what we call as a cave columns. Okay? Like I said, like do not touch any cave formation that we have in the cave, because one of the important things, the thing that we call like ongoing process that we have in the cave here. Stalactite, stalagmite,
oh, yeah.
For 1 centimeter will take around almost 100 years to fall. Okay, so that is the main reason we say like we don't touch any cave formation that we have in the cave here. Oh, inside the cave we have much more high ceilings.
Here.
Bird nest up here.
Oh, where?
In the hole.
Oh, yeah.
As you can see that we have water dripping around this area. When I said that when we have this kind of dissolving process in the cave, especially in the limestone area over here.
Actually, here is not really that dark. If you bring your own mobile phone, turn on the torchlight, it's bright enough for you to explore this area. And yeah, just be gentle. Let's check out those like jellyfish thing. It's a little bit like an alien formation, but it's really beautiful. See that?
Like I said, like the cave system over here was like underwater a long time ago. You can see rock, pebble, and clay around this area. So this is the cave sediment that will prove this cave was underwater a million years ago. Some of the sediments up there as well. So this cave actually long time ago full with water, but when the water dry out, some of the water wash away some of the sediments that we have in the cave. But around this area, you might see like we have cave curtain above your head here. Okay, the cave curtains, maybe a sun, jellyfish formations around this area. Yeah, it almost looks like Captain Barbossa face. Pirate of Caribbeans. And then we have the big jellyfish here. Okay. Do you have any cave in Belgium?
Yes.
Big one? Small one?
It's quite big actually.
Yes.
So you can come to Belgium.
Nicholas, you must be very proud of your cave.
Yes, I'm very proud of my cave, especially for Deer Cave and Sarawak Chamber.
Mm-hmm.
Because Sarawak Chamber, you can fit around 47 inside it.
Wow.
The biggest chamber that we have in the world.
Wow. Beautiful. So we are making a loop from the entrance, going up and going down. So far, it's still comfortable. Honestly, it's not very tiring. Not smelly at all, chilling. You get to see a lot of the beautiful shape like this.
Come closer. Oh, sorry, I didn't see you up there. We have bats.
Oh.
Here.
Oh yeah.
Mr. Bruce Wayne.
Very lonely.
Okay guys, like this is one of the examples that people been touched a long time ago. So this is one of the stalactite that we have in the cave, like people like visiting here and then like another person touching it all the times. Okay, like I said, like this kind of like stalactite and stalagmite, they are formed by crystal calcites. If you come close, if you shine your light, you can see something like sparkling, like crystal around this area.
Mm-hmm.
See it?
Mm-hmm.
So when we have a walk in the forest just now, we are sweating. So in our hand, we have fatty acids. So when you walk in the cave and then suddenly you touch the cave formations, you will transfer the fatty acid to the formation that we have in the cave. So the fatty acid will attack some of the surface mm-hmm. around this area. Maybe another person doing the same things. Maybe 25% doing the same things. So this area will cover by fatty acid, so they will not growing anymore.
So this will be a seashells that been compressed to each other by the seawater with the limestone long time ago. So this is one of the proof. So if you're doing this Lagang cave walk for the fast lane, you might see more things happening in the Lagang cave. You can see like cave formation that been mixed together with the ocean's minerals or living things. You can see fossil inside it as well in the Lagang cave.
This part is beautiful as well. So when you come out over here and then you really see the difference from the one at the bottom. Let's keep walking and then we will try to visit another cave. We have a good time in this Lang cave and really see a lot of beautiful different types of formation. Now we are going to the Deer Cave. Outside the Deer Cave is like got a very strong yogurt smell. It should be fine. So this is the walkway to the Deer Cave. Is that smelly?
It is.
It is beautiful and windy right over here. Still a very comfortable path to go into the cave. So we'll show you how inside looks like. It is looks a little bit like the cave in what they call Makassar, the Toraja, where the people they put the mummified body inside. So it's beautiful here. Big difference with the Lang cave and the Nia cave. Over here you can see a short path and then you can inside a very very spacious cave. It is amazing over here and I saw a post spot here. So why you didn't tell us that we can post a postcard here? We should do it earlier. Yeah.
But long time ago, people always do the post the card from here. But now it's like because we have the one very close to the office in front.
Oh, so you can just do it right there.
Yeah.
Oh, but you'll be.
Here we need to collect the.
Very difficult, right?
Collect the card again.
It's beautiful here. Fresh air here, and I don't smell yogurt here. Interesting. Yeah. a little bit yogurt smell now.
String? Oh yeah.
Oh, thank you. It's okay.
Yeah.
There are lots of spiders here. Watch out.
Yeah.
Okay, we are going to the VIP room. So we have about a few minutes of briefing at the entrance. Get to know about the cave, some history. So tips for you when you look up, don't open your mouth. So I guess that's why you very smart, Olivia, put on a smart mask. Okay. So far, so good.
Where's Daniel?
Oh. It's too dark, I can't see him. Yeah, we can just walk and then meet him at the front. So if you have time, check on the water. Oh, I see fishes. And then you get to see some shrimp. Nicholas, tell us about the story about why they named this cave Deer Cave. And then also telling us that I thought it's a cricket. The water here is actually salty. It's because of the bad pool.
Abundance of fish down here.
Oh, wow.
So different type of like,
guys.
So, hurry up. That's lucky. You see the fish, you see the soft shell turtle around this area.
The fish.
So that's kind of like size. 8 to 9 kilos of soft shell turtle, the body weight. So this kind of like size of the head, because I know. Because I do always doing the free dive on the outside of the national park, like free dive, doing some spear guns. So this kind of like size, I will know about like how much is body weight for the soft shell turtle.
Is this a protected?
Protected animal.
Oh,
yes.
Okay.
So we are not allowed to catch them. We just take photo and leave. Okay. So when I say like we get to the VIP launch just now, then.
Oh, there it is.
You can see the forehead, the nose, chin.
Okay. The reason why we visit this cave is this one. It's quite dark right here, and my light attract a lot of fly. So, if you want to see something far for video, you need a very good torchlight to shine out everything. Then I'm using the LED light. It's good to spread out a little bit, but basically you can't see much. And we are getting to the second zone and we smell something. Oh, the dead bird. Oh, poor thing. So I think someone stepped on it. Set. And the smell is getting stronger and stronger. And we are going to second zone and oh my god, sleepwalking. I'm sure I might have some crocodiles here. The smell is getting very strong at the zone 2, and then I'm very lucky I did not see any cockroaches yet. Because at the cockroach love to eat the poo poo. So let's keep on walking. I'll show you whatever I can see. So Olivia is very smart to wear the mask so get lesser bad smell. Honestly speaking, compared to Nia Cave and the path walkway is more comfortable than the Nia Cave right over here. After the second zone, we are going to the dark zone. It's okay, the dark zone and very, very dark inside. So if I switch off the light, it's just completely dark. You see nothing. So far,
still pleasant to trekking around. Very interesting exploration about the cave and a story telling about an accident from a guide and a client. Then we are heading back to the entrance. About 5 p.m. If you're lucky, we can see the bat flying out because we can see that it's raining outside, rain heavily. So this is what you can expect from the way out from the dark zone. So fun fact that the bat pool, they call it guano. And then if you go to Nyah Cave, you can see a lot of people actually collecting the guano as sell as a fertilizer. Beautiful butterfly accidentally fly inside this cave. Good luck to it. And I try to catch up because there's a lot of guano. That means that there will be have cockroaches. Just ended the tour. Tired?
Yes.
Smelly, right, inside?
Yeah, but it's good now. It's not so bad. It really just wasn't so bad.
Okay, for yourself.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, what do you think about this cave? Worth to visit?
Really impressive.
Yeah, it's very high. Very
I think tall. That the ton of the pool of the bed is very scary. You know, I only saw one cockroaches.
Yes, I know. I saw Goldmark. I didn't mention it.
Oh, you saw that?
I saw one.
Yeah. Oh, I saw a scorpion.
Serious?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Why you didn't let me know? Inside the cave?
Yes.
Oh my god. Okay. So we are very lucky also. We saw quite a lot of things like the lantern bug and what else?
The turtle.
Turtle. Oh yeah, the turtle. And we saw the fish.
Amazing.
And like the bat, all these things. So now we are waiting for 5:30. It's rain heavily now, but the guy was saying that there's a chance that the hungry bat might fly out. So we sit here very comfortably. So you have to be shameless, ask the people say whether can sit here, or otherwise you have to be right crowded with other people. Very comfortable is like our own private sitting area.
Veranda.
Sit right over here, just perfect angle to wait for the bat to fly out. So tips for you to visit this place. Actually, you can wear shorts. You don't have to wear a long pant. Wear cover shoe. Bring a very good powerful torchlight. Bring drinking water. Bring some snack. And then no mosquito.
No mosquitoes in the cave.
No.
Yeah.
No
the mosquitoes. The reason why is all the bat will finish and eat all the mosquito. So did you get any bite?
No.
Yeah. So visit here. Bring a mask and put some perfume because the inside might be like an expired yogurt. And no more tips. Any tips for you to visit this cave?
Just enjoy.
Yeah.
By the ride.
Okay, they enjoy, I enjoy, you might get enjoyed. Unless that you are not physically fit, then sorry, it's your problem. So let us wait and then I will let you know that if you see any beautiful bunch of the bat fly out. If you can't see any, rainy day, you can come another day, or you stay in Marriott Hotels to enjoy your drink in the swimming pool. You can see them from the swimming pool as well. It's still raining, so we give the bat the chance to show off their wing. By 6 p.m. then we will leave. Then in this video, you'll get to expect that how the bat actually fly out and how will it be, because we have no idea when and when the first one comes up and how it will be. We saw bat actually flying out, not from the cave. When we are walking back to take the car, they are flying low. That's a cute tree frog. Goodbye. Sharp eye from identified by Ollie. So I can see it clear on my video. But we can't find the what they call the frog yet. It's so cute. There are frog that keep saying what? Can you hear that? What? What do you want? What do you want?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
It's so silly.
I think it's going to get the legs out soon. It is dark now and then we are still trying our way to walk out. So you have to estimate some walk out time. Make sure you have some food with you. It's very important.